We lived happily ever after.
Yeah, that's right. Hey, everybody. And fingers crossed you guys can hear us because the interface seems to have changed in Facebook. But anyway, we're just going to go live. And welcome to July. Welcome to the...
Wait, who are we?
Oh, I'm sorry. We're the
ClydesDales.
And we are coming from ClydesDales house. Clubhouse, I'm sorry. Exactly. And we are going to play a couple of songs from exactly, or almost exactly, 40 years ago today.
What?
Yeah, right? Mm-hmm. So, middle of the show, everybody knows, is when people do the kind of obscure stuff. And these songs that we're about to play, they're one-hit wonders, maybe.
Yeah, one-hit wonders, deep cuts, 80s deep cuts.
Regional hits.
Yeah.
So, anyway, this first song we're going to play was released 40 years ago today. Also, it was released 45 years ago, but not today. And 57 years ago today. These songs came out.
Oh, and the lead singer of the most popular version of this song came out when he was a teenager.
Exactly. So, this song... originally by Gloria Jones, came out a second time by Gloria Jones.
G-L-O-R-I-A.
Exactly. And we're going to play it for you now.
Ooh.
All right.
Intentional.
That song wasn't intended to be about the AIDS crisis, but not surprisingly,
it was. It became an anthem. There's an industrial band called Coil that released yet another version shortly later in the 80s that was right on the nose about AIDS. And Mark Allman, the singer from Soft Cell, appeared in that video as a lover who did not care that his lover was in the hospital having been stricken with AIDS.
Right. Well, say, Dale, this next song we're going to do.
Killed.
Right. Okay. Came out, 3 days from now. So July 10th.
In the past.
In the past, in 1981. So 40 years, 3 days from now. Yeah. And, you know, Dale.
In the Kelvin time.
Sure, sure.
Yeah.
If you guys have seen Inside Llewellyn Davis, that Coen Brothers movie, have you seen it, Dan?
Oh, it's delightful, yes.
Yeah, it's good?
Yeah, it's a good movie. It's a okay. Coen Brothers movie. It's a great movie.
Sure. Well, this story that we're about to tell you really quickly is about another struggling singer-songwriter who grew up in Buffalo, New York, and then fled the possibility of being drafted.
Oh, a conscientious objector,
yes,
if you
exactly.
will.
Yes, yeah. Exactly. Okay. He moved to Toronto in 1966, changed his name, added Matthews, the last of his name. His original name, James Ambrose Johnson Jr.
Oh, his name is my name, too.
Yeah, exactly. So he moved to Toronto, started hanging out in coffee shops, befriended struggling unknowns at the time, Joni Mitchell and Neil Young.
Ooh.
Actually, started a band with Neil Young called...
The Canaries.
No, the Minor Birds. Oh. But the they decided they were going to tour. They got signed. They went to Detroit. He had an opportunity to be in front of Stevie Wonder. He sang a song for Stevie Wonder. Stevie Wonder said, "You should change your name again.
And you should get out of my house. I have no idea how you got here."
True, except for that last part. And but unfortunately, he was then immediately arrested and served 1967 in jail for draft dodging.
The Summer of Love, not for this person.
Not for this person at all. But he then did go on to write some great songs and become a chart-topping
mega superstar.
Yeah, mega superstar. So
we'll have to bring it down a little bit now.
Right, right. A little folksy, but hey. Two acoustic guitars.
Such a pretty scene. She's alright. She's alright.
That song seems shorter than I remembered it.
It does, but yeah, you know,
almost like chorus is missing or something.
Nah. It's just a little bit of an arrangement. It's choices we make. So, you guys, it's a pretty quick one, but we want to say thank you again for joining us in July.
Yeah, we know you're all busy.
Right. And for those of you who are watching this later, say tomorrow or the next day or the day after.
Or even the day after that.
Yeah, just try and remember that this came out on the 7th, the same day that Teen Love came out, and 3 days away from Super Freak. But we can't not mention there are some other songs that we aren't playing.
Yeah, we couldn't get around to, but...
From July. And no doubt, if you're looking around... You're going to go to the Rolling Stone. You're going to go to the Pitchfork. They're going to mention a song that's coming out, that actually came out 40 years ago, tomorrow, on the 8th. And
let's just play it. One, two, three, four. Side sound, the radio's going to stay.
Enjoy you anymore. Yes, I just don't enjoy you anymore. I miss you so.
can't talk about REM and when they came out without also mentioning Peter Holsapple and the DBs. That song that we started playing was called Black and White. It came out in January 15th of 1981. Mm. And actually both the first two DBs albums came out in 1981.
Yeah.
Peter Holsapple.
Cocaine.
Sure. Peter Holsapple and Chris Stamey were friends that formed the DBs. They introduced Pete Buck, a young upstart Pete Buck, to Mitch Easter, who had only recorded two other bands in his parents' garage in North Carolina. And Mitch Easter is responsible for some of the best sounding best jangle pop
yes.
ever. Please do look him up at Let's Active, mm-hmm. and also look up some Game Theory. Anyway, that concludes our four-song set.
What? Just a little gift from us to you.
Sure. And our next show is August 1st.
We better start practicing.
Yes, we better. But here's the thing. August 1st is huge. It is huge for 1981. So, we'll see you later.